will be Jwala, and the pilot for today is Indrani, and the co-pilot is Manbir. So kindly put your mic on mute. Over to you, Indrani.
Thank you, Sonal. Good afternoon, everyone. So today we are going to visit.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Yes. Today we are going to visit Venezuela. So here is the map of Venezuela. It is the country on northern coast of South America, as you can see. It is consisting so many islands and islets in the Caribbean Sea. Here you see in the map. So now this is also a map of Venezuela. So Caracas is the capital country of Venezuela. Orinoco River is the main river over there. And Lake Maracaibo is the main lake over there. So Venezuela is known for its hills and mountains. Now, the official name of Venezuela is Bolivarian Republic of Venezuela. It is a country in northern South America. Venezuela is bordered by Colombia, Brazil, Guyana, and Caribbean Sea. Capital city, as I already told, that it is Caracas. Major cities, Caracas capital, Maracaibo, Valencia, Barquisimeto, Maracay. And population, the people of Venezuela are called Venezuelans. Venezuela has 45th largest population of any country in the world. So government of Venezuela is republic that is divided into 23 states and a capital district. So the president of Venezuela is Nicolas Maduro. Language, the official language is Spanish. Literacy rate, about 93%. You know about literacy rate? So people who can read and write are literate. So the literacy rate over there is 93%. Do you know the literacy rate of India?
Ma'am, can I tell?
Yes.
43%.
No, it is updated. It is now 78% approximately. So the religion is Roman Catholic 96%, Protestant 2%, other is 2%. Now coming to the flag of Venezuela.
So it is,
yes, it is very colorful. I will clear
Ma'am,
all your
Kerala,
doubts.
Kerala is most literate. What?
Nessa, I will clear all your doubts after my presentation. So this is the flag of Venezuela. It is so colorful. So as you can see, Venezuela's flag is yellow, blue, and red, horizontal tricolor with 8 white stars in semicircle in the center. The coat of arm on the yellow strip on the hoist sides. Here you can see 7 stars. Now what 7 stars represent? It represents 7 provinces. So 7 provinces are Barcelona, Barinas, Caracas, Cumana, Margarita, Merido, and Trujillo. So they have 7 stars. The 8th star, the Bolivar star, was added in 2006 to honor Simon Bolivar, who was the leader of Venezuela. So red represents courage and blue represents Venezuela's independence from Spain. The flag has a height to width ratio of 2:3. Now geography. So the climate is tropical. You know what is tropical climate? So it's written that it's hot and humid, but more moderate in highlands. Major rivers, the Rio Orinoco rivers, flows into Venezuela from Colombia, flows northeastward across Venezuela into Caribbean Sea. So lakes are Lago Maracaibo and Lago Valencia. Mountain ranges, the Andes Mountain and the Maracaibo lowland in the northwest. Highest point, Pico Bolivar, which is 5,007 meters above sea level. It is located in northwestern Venezuela. Lowest point is Caribbean Sea at the sea level. So the natural resources which are found in Venezuela are petroleum, natural gas, iron ore, gold, bauxite, other minerals, hydropower, and diamonds. Major industries over there are petroleum, construction materials, food processing, textiles, iron ore mining, steel, aluminium, motor vehicle assembly. So they have also agricultural products, which are corn, sorghum. Do you know what is mean by sorghum? So in India, we call it jowar. So sorghum is that only. Sorghum, sugarcane, rice, bananas, vegetables, coffee, beef, pork, milk, eggs, and fish. So these are the agricultural products over there. So now I will show you Rio Orinoco and this mountains and Lake Maracay. Now the capital is Caracas. The official name of Caracas is Santiago de Leon de Caracas. It is the capital and the largest city of Venezuela. Yes, Nessa, you want to say something? You have raised your hand?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Nessa.
Kerala is the most.
Yes,
literally.
Yes, yes, yes. Thank you. So located, the location of Caracas is along the Guairi River in the northern part of the country within the Caracas Valley of the Venezuelan coastal mountains range. So the valley is close to the Caribbean Sea. Here you can see the picture of this Caracas city. Now here are some facts about Caracas city. The center of the city is still cathedral. Cathedral means there is a large place to worship. So it is located near Bolivar Square. Though some considered the center to be Plaza Venezuela, located in Los Cabos area. So the Caracas Stock Exchange and Petróleos de Venezuela, PDVSA, are headquartered in Caracas. So Caracas has some of the tallest skyscrapers in Latin America, such as Park Center Towers. The Museum of Contemporary Art of Caracas is one of the most important in South America. I will show you the Museum of Caracas later in my presentation. So they have Empresas Polar. It is the largest company in Venezuela. So Caracas is also Venezuela's cultural capital with many restaurants, theaters, museums, and shopping centers. Now talking about the culture of Venezuela. So today the dominant culture of Venezuela reflects a blend of indigenous Spanish customs as well as regional Caribbean and Andean influence. Venezuelans are often described as warm, welcoming, and open people. They are generally believed in fairness and equality. This is embodied by the national hero Simon Bolivar, as I told that he is leader. He was the leader of Venezuela, of whom they are very proud. However, customs and attitudes can vary significantly depending on person's class, ethnicity or locality, example, rural or urban area. Perceptions of the culture often especially differ between those from different social and economical classes. So this is the costume of Venezuelan festival. This is dancing corpus. They wear masks over their head and they dance like that. It's very colorful. Now talking about currency of Venezuela, there are coins of 1, 5, 10, 12.5, 25, and 50 cents, and 1 Bolivar in circulation.
Ma'am?
Yes, Nessa?
How to keep the how to pronounce the currency of Venezuela?
Venezuela, Bolivars.
Okay, ma'am, thank you.
Okay, so the denominations, the 8 star of Venezuelan flag and the waves representing the bands of national flag. In reverse, the national coat of arms is shown and the name of minting country. The coin of one Bolivar bears the portrait of Simon Bolivar in obverse and denomination. The coat of arms and inscription Bolivarian Republic of Venezuela in reverse side. So they have coins like this and the note. So I will tell you one interesting fact about Venezuelan Bolivar. First coin, everybody please mute yourself. So the first coins with the name Republic Venezuela arrived on the country in 1844. And they were cents, half cents and quarters of cent made in copper minted by England. Standard size of the bank notes is 156 into 69 millimeter. And they features in the observe the portrait of some national hero, and in the reverse, some patterns of local fauna. Here you can see. Now, airlines to Venezuela. There is no airlines with direct flight from India to Venezuela. So they have major airlines like Turkish Airlines, TK. Here you can see the logo of Turkish Airlines, Iberia, TAP Air Portugal, Air Europa, Air Jamaica, Avior Airlines, Laser Airlines, plus Ultra Linear Areas, Cartago Airlines, Copa Airlines. Now, languages of Venezuela. So about 40 languages are spoken in Venezuela. The country's official language is Spanish. Most common foreign languages spoken in Venezuela are Italian, Portuguese, Chinese, Arabic, and English are the most commonly spoken language. So, economy of Venezuela. So, it is based primarily on petroleum. Venezuela is the sixth largest member of OPEC by oil production. Do you know what is the full form of OPEC? So it is Organization of Petroleum Exporting Countries. So do you know where is the headquarter of OPEC? We have visited that country. I can give you. Okay, I can give you one hint that the country starts with the letter A.
Australia.
No. So it is having headquarter in Vienna, Austria. Okay? We have visited, right?
Yes, ma'am. Austria.
Yes, it's Austria. So Venezuela manufactures and exports heavy industry products such as steel, aluminium, and cement. Manufacturing includes electronic and automobiles as well, beverages and foodstuffs. Venezuela exports rice, corn, fish, tropical fruit, coffee, pork, and beef also. Now moving forward to my presentation. So it is a traditional dish of Venezuela.
Ma'am?
Yes, Nessa?
Pork means that pig's meat, right?
Yes. So it is called pabellón criollo. So it is a traditional dish of Venezuela. The local version of the rice and beans combination found throughout the Caribbean. It is a plate of rice, shredded beef in stew and stewed black beans. Here you can see in the picture also. Okay, can you name this? This flower is very known to us. Anybody? It starts with O. I'm giving you one hint. It starts with O. Okay, so it is orchid. So this is the national flower of Venezuela. And it is the national tree. Araguene. And this is the national bird. This is to visit. Like they have kids friendly places, beaches, art and culture, museum, history. So the kids friendly beaches are Angel Falls. Angel Falls is a waterfall in Venezuela. It is the world's tallest uninterrupted waterfall with a height of 979 meters and a plunge of 807 meters. Well, it's quite high. Now, they have so many national parks over there, you know. So now, first national park is Canaima National Park. It is a 30,000 kilometer square park in southeastern Venezuela that roughly occupies the same area as Gran Sabana region. It is located in Bolivar state, reaching the borders with Brazil and Guyana. Now, next is Mokima Park. So it is also a national park. So it is, this park covers 94,935 hectares made up of an exclusively marine areas in western sector, a coastal marine area that includes Gulf of Santa Fe, Mokima Bay, and a mountainous area that covers Turimacquarie Dam watershed. Mokima Park was created to protect the mountain forest of Turimacquarie Range and the country's Eastern Caribbean Sea marine landscape. Now, the next one, they have Canaima National Park. Okay, so they have name similar to this. The Canaima National Park is listed as UNESCO World Heritage. It is usually associated with Angel Falls. And the area around the town of Canaima, but this is actually only a small area of vastly diverse park. The park also encompasses the high plateau of La Gran Sabana and includes more than 100 tepuis tabletop mountains, which raise more than 1,000 meters above the savanna. Now the next, they have Roraima. So Roraima is an island in the sky that has been ingraining people from centuries. With a bizarre rock formation, waterfalls, meat-eating plants. This tepuy tabletop mountains was even inspiration for author Conan Doyle's famous novel, The Lost World. The tabletop mountain of Roraima has an alluring appeal for nature lover and adventure seeker, as you can see in the picture also. Yes, Nahita, you want to ask something? You have raised your hand?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes? Okay. So they have sea beaches like Playa e Agua. Is the most famous tourist development on Margarita Island in Venezuela. So it is famous for its gold sand lined with huge palm trees that give shelter to numerous restaurants that provide service to dinner on the beaches. Now the next one they have, Isla de Margarita. Margarita Island is also known as this. Many charter flights fly directly to Isla Margarita from a variety of international destinations, but it's also possible to take a ferry to the island from Puerto La Cruz on the mainland. Now, the next one is Playa Eliaku. So it is internationally known as one of the 7 best locations in the world, having ideal condition for wine surfing and kite surfing, attracting enthusiasts from all over the world, especially from Europe. It displays a row of hotels, shops, and restaurants close to beachfront, featuring a wide range of facilities and sport gear. Now I will talk about art and culture of Venezuela. So I told you that I will show you Caracas Museum of Contemporary Art. So Caracas Museum of Contemporary Art is a museum of modern art located in Parac Central Complex, Caracas, Venezuela. It is opened in 1974. and was the first museum in Venezuela to offer a specialist art library, formal children's adults learning area, special education department for the blind and multimedia art center. So they have National Art Gallery. It features work for art by Venezuelan artists, and artists such as Camille Pissarro, who spent time in Venezuela. So the collection spanned from five countries, five centuries from the colonial days, featuring colonial characters and the period of Simon Bolivar. So you can see in the picture also, these pictures are so old. Like they have collection span some five centuries. So the pictures are definitely old. Now next one is National Pantheon. So National Pantheon is one of the most important attraction in Caracas. The building was constructed after the 1812 earthquake, when the original church on this site was destroyed that time. So today it is the country's most sacred shrine and houses the remains of prominent Venezuelans, including those of Simon Bolivar. So they have museum, Children Museum of Caracas, Museum of Fine Arts, Museum of Natural Science. Well, it's quite interesting place to visit. Now I will show you one video on that and will end my presentation. Wait, I'm sharing my screen.
So today we're going to learn about America. The capital is Washington, D.C. The currency is dollars. The president of USA is Joe Biden. And Marie Curie was the scientist. Actually, India and America is opposite, means when the sun is over here and when the sunlight comes to India, it becomes morning, and here is America, so it becomes night when there is no sunlight, and when the earth turns very slowly, and then here will become morning. America is going to become morning and India is going to become night. Even sometimes also they have flats. The language is English. And this is the flag. France actually gifted Statue of Liberty in US, gifted to USA. Niagara Falls is so beautiful, everyone wants to go over there. The Grand Canyon, NASA, and even one person went to moon, his name,
Mom, my papa is went to Niagara Falls,
and he went, and the some one person went to the moon, his name is not Abraham Lincoln, it is Neil Armstrong. Universal Studios, Yellowstone National Park, Disneyland, Sea World Adventures Park, the Red Indians, and thank you.
Thank you, Kiona. That was a very good presentation by you. So, do you know that tomorrow we are going to end our tour? So, tomorrow is the last day of our world tour. Are you aware of that?
July 15th, yes.
Ma'am, how many countries have you visited till now?
We have visited, right. Yeah, 40 countries. So we have visited already 39 countries today, and tomorrow we are going to visit our last 40 country.
And ma'am, after that, can I attend that one? What do you call it?
Yes, Miss.
Where do you take us to the zoos, the airport, that one?
Yes, Nessa, I'm not getting you.
Ma'am, it means that she's telling about that the zoos that and airports and amusement parks one.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, Manya.
Ma'am, we didn't went to Vegas.
So we had our 40 country list. So we don't have this country. So we are
doing anything to start.
Yes, Nessa.
We are not going anywhere.
We are, you know, we are starting new ones from 19th of July.
Yeah, what is about?
What is about?
What we are going to do now.
Yes, Nessa. I'm not getting you.
Like in that one, what are you starting from 19 now? What are we going to do in that?
Okay, I will inform you later. So did you enjoy our tour?
Yes, ma'am.
Can I present? Can I tell the fact now?
Sure, Snehita.
The national animal is phenomine.
Yes.
And 1 second, ma'am.
Is the class done?
Yes.
Is yes, the Kiona? Is the class done?
Yeah.
Bye, ma'am. Bye, Nessa.
Bye.
What is
See this? Tomorrow.
Ma'am?
What is this?
Yes, Shubhanita.
Ma'am, actually, when I was joining the tour, the timeline was still 15, but we are ending on 9th.
We are ending on 9th?
Yes, ma'am. When I was joining the world tour, you said that we will end the world tour on 15th.
Yes, ma'am, you tell it.
You don't want to end it? We have completed our 40 countries. You already visited 40 countries, 39 countries today. So we will organize one more tour for you if you don't want to end this.
I'll make one more tour.
You want one more tour?
Yeah.
Okay.
Now I think 41.
Okay.
Places.
Okay.
So today what place? I mean tomorrow what place?
Vietnam.
Okay.
So I already mentioned a task for you. You all will draw a flag of Vietnam, or if anybody wants to make any presentation, you can. Okay? Yes, Nahita.
It is the 33rd largest country in the world with a total area of 353,840 square meters. 916,445 square kilometers. The population of Venezuela is 189 million. While its capital city is home to 1.9 million people. The country's official language is Spanish.
Okay. So we are starting our new event from 19th of July. Same world tour of 30 countries in 45 days. Okay? So see you tomorrow. That's all about our today's tour.